very, very unfair fight right now. Wow! 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 Holy shit! Holy shit!
Easy peasy lemon squeezy!
Guys, welcome back to my channel SR83 Evits, and we are doing something different today. This is a reaction for Glory 38 in Chicago. It's the Super Fight series. I've done this before once and it was a complete hit because a lot of viewers on my channel for this video. So I'm going to do this again. This Super Fight series will feature Myrtle Groenhart versus Tong Chai, and I'm very curious what will happen in that fight, because Myrtle Groenhart is a beast and Tong Chai is just a good Thai fighter, and yeah, I'm really curious how that's gonna play out, because the Dutch people known for their Thai boxing qualities, so I'm very curious what's gonna play out there. One quick mention, I have social media, and you can follow me on Twitter or follow me on Facebook. The links will be in the description down below or at the end of this video. So without further ado, let's go into this reaction video and watch what will happen when Glory goes to battle. See you in a bit.
What's impressive there is that reach that he has, and that's what he's going to have to do to keep Blavatsky away from him.
Very curious what's going to happen here.
But he's been off for 3 years, where Blavatsky's been a little bit more consistent. Like I said before, he had 8 professional fights last year, so that momentum could play in his favor.
Here are the Glory rules. If you're not familiar, we just have 3 rounds, 3 minutes each. Hit the ground running and kicking, ladies and gentlemen. Punches, kicks, and knees are the legal strikes. 3 knockdowns in a round or 4 in the fight results in a TKO.
Looking at our scoring, each round will be scored using a 10-point must system. We're looking for knockdowns, damage inflicted, clean scoring strikes with an emphasis on spectacular techniques. And finally, if there's no clear advantage, judges will look at aggressiveness.
Our first bout of the evening, scheduled for 3 3-minute rounds in the Glory lightweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the black corner, a WKN world champion and World Max Tournament runner-up. His professional record, 17 wins, 11 losses, 1 bout scored even. He makes his Glory debut tonight. Standing 5'7" 1/2", 1.72 meters. He weighed in at 154 1/2 pounds, 70.1 kilos. Fighting tonight out of Novosach, Poland, ladies and gentlemen, Lucas Boom Boom Blavatsky. Here now is his opponent, standing on my left and fighting out of the white corner, a WKU Muay Thai world champion. His record stands at 44 wins, 8 losses, 2 draws, 24 of those wins by knockout. At 6'1/2", 1.84 meters. He weighed in at 100.
He's eager to go.
69.6 kilos. Here in Chicago tonight, fighting out of Denmark, here is Nicholas the Destroyer Larsen.
Straight out of McIntyre. Hi, Glory
and
girls.
The man inside the Glory ropes, your referee is Paul Nichols.
Okay, gentlemen, you understand the rules that you're fighting to. Protect yourself at all times, obey my commands at all times. Do you have any questions? Touch gloves if you like. Great, back to your corners.
People think it's an aggressive sport, but you can see how much sportsmanship is in this competition.
A premier world-class striker in Blavatsky.
And we're going to see what that layoff did, if it built his confidence.
Aggressive leg kicks.
He's still where it may take a round or two for him to get comfortable again.
Nice. They get this. They give knees.
Just getting back to this moment took so much energy.
Wow.
Mentally and physically, what does Larsen have left in the tank?
His style is, he classifies as very tricky. He's going to constantly try to confuse Plavesky, who's more of a pressure fighter who likes to come forward. And already you see Larson wanting
a very energetic fight
versus that forward pressure.
Tried that flying knee and ended up throwing a right hand and a swing and miss by Plavesky, who describes himself as strong, stubborn, and self-confident like any other Polish person.
Yeah, he doesn't want to move backwards. He constantly wants to come forward and throw his hands. And being the shorter fighter, I like that he's really going to start utilizing those low kicks.
Low kick.
Especially when he gets on the inside with his boxing, perfect opportunity to finish with the low kick.
See how much Larson likes the knees.
He needs to be careful though. When he's coming in like that, his head's exposed.
Wow.
That's where you're going to see Plavesky try to use those overhand shots.
And he spun Plavesky around with a low kick, and there's a hard one delivered by the Polish fighter. And another one. Larson says he's inspired by Remy Bojanski, who, as you know, the Flying Dutchman.
Yeah, he's known for those flying knees, Remy. And a lot of people really look at Remy as one of the best to use those knees.
Remy, wow, that one recently hit. Calling out our heavyweight champion Rico Verhoeven, wants to come out of retirement to fight him. Everybody wants to fight Rico.
And we even have Gökhan Saki calling out Remy Bojanski. A lot of potential good matchups.
Right. The overhand right caught the ear there of Larson. What? Sometimes that can be a shot that gets you a little discombobulated. Right in the temple.
Wow, nice knee.
Knee goes into the arm from Larson. Only three rounds in glory.
Wait.
3 minutes each. Not much time to get your work in. So the pace is extremely high. So too is the knockout ratio. Push kick there from Larson.
Whoa.
Larson still
that
looks
was
very relaxed.
It doesn't relaxed?
Look like he's this layoff has done anything to his comfort in the
I think
you can see the welts on the outside.
A little
of the left
too much
leg
energetic
of Lukas Plavesky. Those low kicks already taking their toll on Boom Boom.
Oh, that was a nice low kick.
That exit low kick is one of my favorites. As they exit, keep throwing that. They can't block at that point. Plavesky needs to throw some of those kicks back. He was very successful in the early round.
So the first round in 3 years for Larson, a good one. Now let's go inside Glory Rules.
Glory.
So there you have it. Glory Rules, pretty simple and can be pretty violent, that's for sure. Round one, extremely close total strikes. Larson with 25, Plavesky with 26, Joe.
But according to the Glory scoring, you need to look at what did more damage. And it looked like those low kicks of Larson
are doing a lot of damage.
A lot of good damage and some good knees on the inside. That's why I'm giving him the first round.
We asked Plavesky what his strengths were in the ring. He said boxing with a low kick for dessert.
He's been showing it, but in my opinion, he's not throwing it enough.
Plavesky's face is beginning to turn a bright red. So too are his thighs from all those kicks. And there's your total strikes, Joe.
A really energetic
kicks. Yeah,
it's very
close in total strikes landed. And it seems like it's Larson that's really doing a good job, though, at dictating the pace, where Plavesky's looking to counter more.
Plavesky wearing the black gloves, Larson in the white.
And Larson being the taller fighter, he wants to stay outside. That's why I'm surprised he's
nice
using
jab.
His knees so much.
Larson beginning to get more confident as he goes in for the strikes. Another
yeah, don't get
the
confidence.
We've seen four or five of those.
He needs to set them up, though. Keep staying outside. Keep mixing in those low kicks. You can see Plavesky's left leg really starting to show the redness and the damage.
And his right leg isn't much better.
Wow, two low kicks.
Too long. That's the problem. He's waiting too long, and that's why Larson's able to pick his shots on the outside.
In Larson's 44 victories, he does have 24 knockouts. He likes to put his opponents away. And again, Larson leaves the mat.
Wow, that was nice. Overhand, right. Pace
Plavesky
slowing down a bit. Wow, nice one.
We'll see here tonight.
Even though it was on the
block
series.
Coming up next is Pavel Jedrzejczyk.
Now Larson's playing a little bit different. He's using his movement, keeping his distance, staying longer, then mixing in those knees. That's a little better strategy than leading with that knee. Set it up with some strikes on the outside.
And considering how many flying knees we've seen, what could he perhaps fake a flying knee and throw a different strike that might catch his Polish counterpart off balance?
Well, I mean, the right kick is a good option to mix in the right kick or the front kick. There's so many different weapons to set up that knee, but a front kick would be a good option. Good body kicks, low kicks, many options.
What happened there?
But Plavesky's waiting too long. He needs to be first.
Especially when he gets inside. An obvious height and reach disadvantage. And that right hand connects, and then a knee to the solar plexus. Plavesky backing up here against the ropes.
Larson sees it.
Teeing off.
Go.
Great.
The best moment of the fight for the Denver
fighter.
There's a right hand which beat
him
with a spinning back fist.
It was without a block.
The distance, and that put him on the inside.
No defense.
Now Plavesky's got no defense.
And there's a knee, and the bell comes just in time.
Saved by the bell.
Finishing the second.
When he did that backhand, that backhand fist, he had no defense, and Larson
let's
just dropped.
Larson in this
round three.
Round three. Let's
three
go.
3 minutes to go. Can Plavesky dig deep, find an answer, or will Larson put him away?
What Larson threw near the end in that second round, he started mixing in that uppercut. And like you said earlier, what's another option other than the knee? The uppercut's a good option.
Especially that two landed.
Plavesky puts the earmuffs on.
Plavesky landed a good overhand right there. That's what he needs to do. Try to catch Larson coming in with those knees.
And Plavesky with a nasty cut under his left eye. And another knee lands right to that spot. And another knee. Plavesky
in the valley.
Hits the ropes.
The way he mixes up his hands and boxing, incredible.
Now we're getting somewhere.
As soon as Plavesky really shells up and covers his defense, that's when Larson mixes those knees. Well done.
Larson is simply being the boss
now. He's dominating.
But Larson, I would like to see mixing those kicks. There's that exit low kick, would have been a perfect opportunity.
And how about the cardio level that Larson's showing? It takes a lot of energy to throw those flying knees, and he still looks fresh.
But what he does is he moves outside. Like right now, this is his recovery time. He's staying loose, just lightly tapping, and then he's going to mix in those power shots.
Minute and a half to go now.
In
the clinch,
that hurts.
This is where Larson has been delivering some massive knees.
Larson needs to be careful. He needs to, if he initiates the clinch, he needs to throw a strike right away. He can't grab, move a little bit weight. He needs to throw those knee strikes right away.
The question now for Larson, does he go for the kill, go for the knockout, or does he play it safe and kind of lose control?
And again, his defense is gone. When he does those, like I said, the backhand fist or doing a throwback kick,
Larson
he has no defense,
and
Larson is
and
jumping in
it. Listen, I want to be back on that glory card in 2 months when we go to Copenhagen, provided he didn't get injured. And
what the hell was that?
Injured right now. He almost jumped over the top rope there.
The thing with knees when you're fighting, though, it's you hit a lot of elbows a lot of times, so you can get a lot of damage after the fight if you're clipping a lot of elbows. So you don't really know until
when that adrenaline goes.
Oh, I can tell you right now, Plavesky is already hurting. Doesn't need to wait an hour.
Wow,
right
another one
connects from Larson.
I still would like Larson to mix those low kicks. He did so much damage with them. He's just relying on his boxing and his knees. It's still doing damage, but he could easily and land a little better if he mixed
another
in his kicks.
Landed.
And leaping right hands. You don't see Larson plant, get a good foundation, and throw hands. He's always moving his body, walking down his opponent, as he's doing right here. 10 seconds to go. And the Danish destroyers.
He's just
returned to the ring. Was a fantastic one.
The last 10 seconds
Nicholas
he threw some in.
Ladies and gentlemen,
welcome back, Nicholas Larson.
Let's see if Joe's right
for
the official
won.
Decision. Here is
Plavesky was actually not really anywhere.
After three rounds of kickboxing, we go to the judges' scorecard. Here now are the totals. All three judges scored about the same. 30-27, a unanimous decision for your winner, Nicholas Larson.
And of course,
Nicholas Larson.
It was earned.
His winning ways and
so let's get to the next fight.
For this young guy.
Opponent tonight, his opponent is an illusion.
So
it's
Daniel Morales
himself.
Against
Pavel
Yedrzejczyk, another Polak.
He is a veteran, and he has
I've seen Morales a couple times. The tall Yedres. Jesus, what a name! In it, at least Paul, I haven't seen him fight before.
He does have a good amateur background in Muay Thai, MMA, and boxing, but he's still new to this kickboxing game.
Paul is the more experienced, at least in Glory. Each time he's in the ring. He had more fights.
This welterweight matchup scheduled for 3 3-minute rounds in the Glory welterweight division.
Hi, Glory girl.
Introducing first, fighting out of the black corner, a five-time world Muay Thai and kickboxing champion. His record, 21 wins with 7 losses, 1 bout scored even, 6 of those career wins coming by way of knockout. At 5 feet 11 inches tall, 1.80 meters, he weighed in at 168.5 pounds, 76.4 kilos. He's here tonight out of Wrocław, Poland. Ladies and gentlemen, here is Paweł Dergi Jędrzejczyk.
Oh, they don't like him that much. Maybe more Mexicans over there.
12-3 in the amateur ranks of Muay Thai. He comes tonight in search of his first professional kickboxing victory. He stands 5 feet 11 inches tall, 1.81 meters, and he weighed in at an even 170 pounds, 77.1 kilos. Fighting out of Mexico City by way of Chicago, Illinois.
Oh, of course. He's a homeboy.
Dave Smith. Step up. Fighter. Fighter. Step up. You guys won't know the rules. Clean, fair fight. Start to finish. Touch him up. Step back. Good luck to both of you. Touch him up.
Very, very straight faces.
What kind of fight do you expect to see here?
I expect more of Jędrzejczyk really trying to push the pace with his volume in action, where I'm curious to see how Morales approaches this fight. He has good movement and good boxing, but in his last fight, he showed that he can fight that Dutch-style kickboxing. He spent about 2.5 months in Holland training for his last fight, so he has a good mix of boxing and Dutch-style kickboxing, so it's interesting to see which one will work for him.
Another very side defense.
Basically came running out of his corner to put the pressure on Morales, and he hasn't let up.
That's Jędrzejczyk's style. He just keeps coming forward.
Said he wants to break Morales down.
Morales is deciding to fight a little bit more on the outside, use his angles, use his boxing.
And while Morales does have an 0-3 record here in Glory, that record is somewhat deceiving considering his level of opposition.
And he just right away was thrown into some top level. He came in and having a last fight at Glory 27 Chicago, had
nice.
A tough fight with Casey Green.
Point just landed.
Two tough
nice
fights.
Kick.
Nice one.
An uppercut there for Morales.
Yeah, that was a good finish, but he had two excellent fights against Abang. So he really needs this win.
Oh, nice one. Nice dodge.
Veterans here in Glory. So Green, top level competition.
Right nice low kick landing.
Standing right there and trading with Jędrzejczyk.
There's that mix between that boxing movement and that Dutch-style combination fighting.
We see more landing right now than the last fight. There was more defense in the last fight. This Pollock is giving a little more of the for the money.
That's a good shot against a forward pressure fighter.
I was going to ask you, what's the best strike to throw when you're constantly moving backwards? I assume that's the one.
Well, it's different. If you're moving backwards, they're called draw attacks. So you're pulling your opponent in. You can use straight rights. You can use uppercuts. You can use low kicks. He just needs to throw a little bit more. Morales is waiting a little too long, in my opinion, and he's doing well when he throws back in combinations.
Those punches aren't very hard to landing, but...
1-2 there from Jędrzejczyk.
I don't know if they're doing damage.
Body kick to finish it off. Nice uppercut, Joe's favorite punch.
I haven't seen
about that earlier. You want to see more uppercuts in Glory? There's a
second one. Oh, nice one.
I said it was one of those shots that people don't
that two landed. He's
especially
stunned.
With a guy like Jędrzejczyk's defense, those are the shots.
Yeah, Jędrzejczyk is stunned.
10 uppercuts in this opening round.
Let me tell you, Jędrzejczyk will not go down. If he does, he's going to come back and keep this constant pressure and forward fighting.
They have done damage.
Polish fighters known around the world for their toughness. A right hand from Yeager. Great opening round, and Morales is going to throw and kick to the bell. Jędrzejczyk answering back here. And a body kick from Morales. Great opening round.
Yeah, it is a great opening round. With those uppercuts, he did a lot of damage, I think. With the other punch, I don't know really. At least in my opinion.
So perhaps Morales just two rounds away from his first win here in Glory. Let's hope round two was as good as round one. They start training again. Morales doing a good job adding in those low kicks as well.
Landed again.
But he needs to keep it up.
Wow.
That's a good shot against the
forward pressure. Landing.
But the thing is, that forward pressure of Jędrzejczyk scores well with the judges because it shows him constantly coming forward. He might not be landing as much, but it shows a more dominant position.
Nice one.
Wow, that one landed the open right.
And then a body shot. The Morales walking right through him and again goes to that uppercut. As blood begins to drip out of the mouth of Jędrzejczyk.
That's what he needs. Morales doing well in combinations. But he needs to set that uppercut now. Pavel knows that shot's coming. Mix it up with some hooks, some low kicks, some body kicks. Mix it up.
Head kick there.
Even though he knows it's coming, he's still hitting him with the uppercut.
Morales also accomplished in the MMA world. He won the Combate America's Welterweight Championship.
That's when I first met Morales. I actually was a guest kickboxing coach on Combates Americas, and that's when I first met Morales. And he told me he watched Glory 11, and he knew he was going to be in the ring one day.
Glory 11, right here in Chicago, was sitting with his dad. Said, "Dad, this is what I want to do for a living." And here he is, full circle of life, Joe, in Chicago, fighting.
Nice spinning back fist landed.
Positive thinking.
Left hand.
He is landing a lot. He's getting them also.
The Windy City, they're appreciating the effort they're seeing in this fight from both these athletes.
It's a tough for the crowd to cheer. You have the Polish side and the Chicago side.
Nice move and stick there
from
Morales.
In the body.
He's using that jab to the body, maybe to set up his right hand.
Now Morales is cut under his left eye.
Yep, he blocked it. He blocked his uppercut
to the body. Don't see that too often.
There's that low kick. I'd like to see Morales.
That landed.
You can see Jędrzejczyk trying to bully Morales there in the corner.
He just keeps coming forward. He's one of very tough, very durable. He doesn't stop.
The left lands from Jędrzejczyk. Nice combination, punching a spinning back.
Spinning back fist landed also. This actually is a very nice foul. Interesting.
Morales, but he just hit a counter left hook.
Punches and absorb some big power punches, but no one has been seriously hurt thus far, or at least they haven't showed it outwardly, as again they exchange going to the bell. The end of round two.
Exchange right onto the bell.
They're doing a lot of cumulative damage. They're doing more damage as the fight goes on, rather than really setting up that one big power shot. It's more of that cumulative damage. It's another fight.
And if you look at the spelling of the name Jędrzejczyk, it looks a lot like Joanna Jędrzejczyk's name, the Polish UFC champion.
They're actually friends.
Boom,
she
right
texted
the bell.
Before this fight, wished him good luck.
They also did some training in Thailand together.
So we know she's watching right now on UFC Fight Pass, cheering her countrymen on. And he's got a lot of work to do here against Morales, but that body kick landed.
Couple of shades landing.
They constantly counter back. They won't let the other get ahead of the points game, so they constantly counter back.
250 punches thrown in this fight. A high output type of encounter here in Chicago.
Call of landing right now, also.
Both guys don't look like they have that power shot to knock the other person out. But like I said earlier, it's that constant
shot and the damage, maybe it takes 4 or 5 shots to land to knock him out, but it doesn't look like they have that single power shot to knock each other out.
And it's interesting, Morales' corner keeps yelling at Morales to come forward, to put pressure on Yedrzejczyk, turn the tables. Nice right hand straight up the gut.
With those counter straight punches.
Looks like Morales is a little bit faster now than Yedrzejczyk.
Oh, nice penny grabber.
Grazed off the forehead.
Got over it.
Trying to get score points with those spectacular techniques. But Morales really hasn't thrown any uppercuts this round.
He's all out, Joe.
Good low kick combination.
Exchanging.
Morales needs to keep his hands up.
His defense, but his defense was
straight punches.
That's when he began also. So.
Exhaustion is certainly settling in.
Yeah.
Morales 240 strikes thrown. Yedrzejczyk 233. That is almost throwing punches nonstop. Go to a gym, find a heavy bag, and hit it 300 times.
Wow, that landed.
And that's with nobody hitting back.
It looks easy when you watch it, and I'm sure a lot of people at home are wondering why their conditioning is not there. But let me tell you, try fighting three-minute rounds as hard as you can.
Stop. 20 seconds to go here. It's been a close fight. It's been an entertaining fight.
Yeah, I think, that landed. Wow.
Go to the bell again.
Whoa, was it a slip?
Slip.
Was a slip.
One more chance to hit him in the face.
Whoa, that landed.
Guy's gonna sit in the pocket, trying to get the last little bit of judge's glory on their side.
Yedrzejczyk thinks he's won it, Joe. So too does Morales.
Yeah, the last two rounds were close.
Towards Morales.
First was Morales.
Welterweight division.
It's Murdo Gruner versus Tong Chai. It's Tong Pinon. Really curious what's going to happen here.
Tons of professional experience, and he's been fighting from
it's not
Sitsang
Pinong,
because
probably
he
would have lost
him
right there, I
but
think.
But you've got to look at Murdo, has 88 professional fights, but
look at that, 168 pro fights.
Yeah, but all in
it's
Muay
not,
Thai.
Yeah, it's not in glory, it's Muay Thai professional fights.
So let's see if that Muay Thai style can do well in the glory ring against a top kickboxer in Murdo.
Murdo has changed his opening song.
In a welterweight division scheduled for 3 3-minute rounds. Introducing first, fighting out of the black corner, a WMC Intercontinental Champion who became Lumpini Champion at the young age of just 17. His professional record, 135 wins with 33 losses, 46 of those wins by knockout. At 5 feet 10 inches tall, 1.78 meters.
It's a very impressive professional career, though. Even though it wasn't Muay Thai, but
fighting out of Bangkok, Thailand.
You had that experience, so you can only not you can just only not do a sweep, so you have to immediately drop a knee when you clinch. But most of the rest is just similar.
Murdo
all the beast to be known.
Even 36 career knockouts. At 6 feet, 1 inch tall, 1.85 meters. He weighed in at 168.5 pounds, 76.5 kilos. Here in Illinois tonight, fighting out of the Netherlands. Here is Mertel, the Predator, Brunhard. And once again your referee is Paul Nichols.
Yeah, that's what he does. He keeps everyone waiting.
Something you don't expect to hear from the Thai Terminator. Said he's a little bit nervous about this fight. Says it's a 50-50 proposition. It could go either way.
This is a very interesting fight, and this is why I think this could be the fight of the night.
Right,
the fight I've been most excited for.
Those low kicks are like fucking whips.
Saw a lot of power punches. this fight should show a lot of power kicks and power knees.
And it's going to be from, a lot of those power kicks are going to come from Tong Chai, and he's looking to already slow Myrtle down with those low kicks. But Myrtle's going to want to get on the inside and see if he can expose Tong Chai's boxing, because Thais traditionally don't box.
This is
going to
be a very, very fast fight, so
I
try to be quiet a lot.
Hold their boxing back.
Punches aren't scored as highly in Muay Thai as kicks are, correct?
That's correct. So you're going to see Tong Chai have really solid kicks, and especially from his camp in Sitsong Pinang, they're known for being power kickers.
We talked about Myrtle Gruenhart sometimes lacking focus. How about Tong Chai, who has very notably in Thailand, it's in the front pages of the paper, has run out of camp sometime to go gamble on chicken fighting. He leaves camp, they can't find him for a few days, they finally wrangle him back in. He has an addiction to chicken fighting on the back streets of Thailand.
Right.
It's probably interesting for him. He's been fighting since he's been 10 years old, so he needs that excitement outside of the training as well. So I can see why he'd be addicted to it.
I don't think there is, at least I hope there isn't, a lot of underground chicken fighting clubs here in Chicago, so hopefully he didn't get into much trouble last night. He looks fresh right now here against Myrtle Gruenhart, halfway through round one.
Throw knees, come on, guys. You
those
know the rules.
Inside knees of Tong Chai do a lot of damage, and once he's on the inside, he does really well.
What?
Hey, you are not here to hold, you're here to fight. You both understand.
Good job. Good job, ref.
Climbing, what?
A couple of punches land from Gruenhart, and that right hand sweeps right across Tong Chai's face.
Speaking to referee Paul Nichols, he knows this fight's going to have a lot of clinching because of Tong Chai, so he's really establishing no clinch rule right away.
You can clinch and hold in Muay Thai. In fact, that's where a lot of the damage is done.
You can clinch and hold, but you got to initiate a knee strike right away.
I remember. He's a little bit...
It's been a sloppy opening round. For sure.
He's a little false.
Tong Chai's kicks, I think they're hurting Myrtle. And those knees on the inside.
Oh, Myrtle gets knocked back against the rope. Hard round to score. It's been such a start and stop affair. You don't see that a lot in glory kickboxing. A right hand lands from Tong Chai.
Tong Chai's looking very impressive, especially with those.
And that may have been a low blow as Myrtle goes down to one knee.
I should give him a warning already, you know?
And you have to remember,
I just don't like
really
him fighting.
English.
Yep.
Public warning number one, you're holding. Okay, next time I deduct a point.
Let's take a look at this knee.
Tong Chai says I got him right in the stomach.
It's hard to tell sometimes with the angles, because sometimes it's the shit goes under and could hit the cup, and the cup vibrates the genitalia there.
I'm in. What?
Well said. Tong Chai trying to moke Ruan down, who beats him with a straight right hand. And look at
this
Tong
is
going to
be a very, very unfair fight right now. Wow. Holy shit. Holy shit. The fuck is happening here? Wow! He was unloading on him! Holy shit! Yeah, this is really going to be an unfair fight right now. Myrtle smelled blood, and he's
going...
Wow!
Going right after Myrtle again.
Yeah, they're not testing gloves.
Terminator.
And Tong Chai was winning that round until Myrtle really... utilize those straight punches.
This is going to be a street fight. Again! Dude!
Michael Todd.
I haven't seen it, but...
1 point. 1 point. 1 point. Neutral.
I didn't see...
There's referee Paul Nichols deducting a point. Really want to establish...
Was it?
Control, but Myrtle really showing. Let's see if we can see a little better angle here. Oh, it's referee calling the stop.
And he caught him in the groin.
certainly sold it. Sometimes you have to do that.
Let's see if Myrtle comes back the same way he did last time he was hurt.
So Tong Chai perhaps losing the first round and now a point behind in the second.
He's not going to... Friggin' hell. This is a very, very street fight.
I'm surprised Tong Chai keeps walking in like that. When he was keeping his distance and throwing those low kicks is when he was doing the most damage and being most successful. But now he's fighting Myrtle's fight, and this is what Myrtle wants.
Jesus Christ!
It's been sloppy, it's been violent.
It's getting even more sloppy than it already was. But that gets the most views. Sometimes you have to get a sloppy fight. What the fuck is happening here?
His trainer told us how nasty Tong Chai could be.
Yeah.
And it's been on display.
I've seen
this
it a couple times.
Throwing knees after the bell, holding, clenching.
That's what you get. Wow, this is a very sloppy fighter. Fight.
So Tong Chai is having a hard time on getting those knees above the waist, and could be the height differential, could be a few different things, but he's got to stay out of that clinch. He needs to throw those kicks on the outside.
If that one landed, if that one landed,
they just missed.
The ref has such a big deal on those guys.
And you can tell, Myrtle turned his back on his opponent. That's a huge no-no in any sport.
At least, also with Sisu Pino.
Tong Chai needs to kick. Don't know why he's continually trying to walk in and use his knees.
I was looking forward to this fight. And it still is a good fight, but... Because
of
Myrtle is very angry at him, and
Tong
Chai is just a very nasty fighter. It's a very lousy fight.
Let's see whose fitness level is higher. They're already exhausted, you can tell. We still have a full round to go.
Ten seconds.
Bernhardt, a former title challenger, believes he can get back to that spot very soon.
Come on.
How soon, you ask? Well, he told us earlier this week. Here now, and look who's in attendance. Felice Herring from the UFC, also Juliana Pena.
Yeah, Felice has a kickboxing background. I know she's a big kickboxing fan, and she always supports here in Chicago.
And plenty to like so far tonight. Round one of this contest was fantastic. They slowed down in the second round, but here we are in the third and final round.
Let's see what's going
to
happen now.
Note,
a lot of clinching.
Was deducted a single point in the second round. So even if you run one round two, Joe, it was a 9-9 round.
Yeah, the first round was close, but it was Myrtle really doing a good job.
Yeah, he
end
won
the
second round.
Hurt,
of,
I still don't
for
understand
sure.
why Tong Chai
nice body punch.
Continually throw knees in the clinch. He was doing so much good damage on the outside with his kicks.
It's probably go down in points.
Even with Myrtle should try to keep that distance, kind of keep that space, keep using his jab and straight punches. Because he knows Tong Chai has to come forward. So he's successful when he's throwing straight punches and constantly keeping distance. Landed a good uppercut there.
And when it comes to punches...
Nice one! Whoa! And he's down! And he's fucking down! Wow! Wow! Knocked down. Yeah. Yeah. I think he's not back in it. He didn't put his hands up. Yeah, it's done. It is done. He didn't put his hands up last time, so he should have stopped it. Stop it. Stop it. He's not gonna get up in time. It's over. He just fucked him up.
Unless
it took him a while though. Damn. It took him a long energetic time. It was spectacular indeed.
As we look at our final statistics, 46 total strikes landed for Bruinhart. Surprisingly, Tung Chai landing 54. And it was those boxing and the punches that did the most damage. Here's Tim Hughes now with the official finish.
Ladies and gentlemen, you watched it as it happened. Our referee Paul Nichols steps in and waves this contest off with an official time of 1 minute 45 seconds of that third and final round, declaring your winner by technical knockout, Mertel Grunhard.
Indeed. So it's Maurice Green against Catalin Morosano. This is going to be interesting. With the puncher on big. Those guys are big.
So he has a big task with the Romanian, who's known for that wild aggressiveness.
This heavyweight battle is scheduled once again for the three-minute rounds. Introducing first,
not sure how that goes.
Fighting out of the black corner. This Romanian southpaw was a 2012 World Grand Prix finalist.
He is big.
His professional record, 42 wins with 10 losses, 25 of those wins by knockout. He makes his glory debut tonight. He stands 5 feet 11 inches tall, 1.80 meters, and he weighed in at an even 237 pounds, 107.5 kilos. Fighting out of Cotnari, Romania, ladies and gentlemen, Catalin, the Carpathian Death, Morosano. Here now is his opponent, standing on the left and fighting out of the white corner.
He finished his glory
debut in San Diego by knockout at Glory 21. His young professional kickboxing career, 4 wins with 3 losses, 2 of those wins by knockout. Standing 6 feet 7 inches tall, 2.01 meters. He weighed in at fight time at an even 271 pounds, 122.9 kilos. Here tonight, from St. Cloud, Minnesota, ladies and gentlemen, Mo the Pirate!
Mo Green!
You want to see the intensity between these two fighters?
The contest is Dave Smith.
Look at the weigh-in from yesterday.
I didn't see the weigh-in, but probably it is tense. Wow. It was
a
tense weigh-in.
There, Joe.
He's bigger than the
in seconds, not minutes. Get ready.
Than the Romanian guy.
Two big power punchers collide here in Chicago.
Morosano is the first southpaw of the night so far. But Maurice says he needs to keep distance, and he's got some knees waiting for Morosano as he comes in.
If that... Wow. Wow, he's fucking lunging. That wasn't expected. He was fucking lunging on Mo Green. Didn't expect that to happen. So a very aggressive opening.
It's pretty easy to determine what each man's strategy is. Morosano, get inside. Mo Green, stay outside.
Morosano does have a good, powerful left kick, so let's see if he uses those low kicks against the taller Green. The
straight if you get hit by a strike of Mo Green, that will hurt.
This is a smart thing to do.
Wow.
Whoa. Punches, so he needs to throw punches down the middle.
Inside leg kick there for Morosano.
Another good shot for Green is that uppercut.
Or
Marzano's used to fighting big, tall heavyweights. In fact, he seems to enjoy it.
He's beat one of Whoa, that one hit it, didn't he? Yeah, he goes down. Oh, no, he didn't go down. I thought he would go down. Yeah, then the knee hit it. The knee landed on his forehead.
A chance to breathe now for a few seconds at least.
A little longer than Marzano predicted.
Low green covering up now.
Wow.
Good job of Marzano.
There's a real heavyweight specialist in this. What?
Marzano's face and nose tells the story of his life. He's been hit probably 10,000 times in the face.
Green needs to stay patient. Stay long with that jab. He needs to stay long with straight punches.
Wow, he's and red all over him already.
Marzano eat a few punches before he
Whoa,
comes in.
That, wow.
Oh, Green's a little wobbly.
Yeah. Is he going down?
He needs to stand up.
Is he going down? I wouldn't expect Mo Green to go down. At least not against Shore guy.
Marzano admitted yesterday to us, listen, I am not the best cardiovascular athlete. I've got to end fights early. I got to win in the first round.
Nice.
Good block by Green there. Green can throw some
A lot of fans of Marzano.
His legs can probably reach Marzano across the ring.
Whoa, the knee landed.
Whoa, ladies and gentlemen.
A very wild opener.
Earl Zimmerman, so he's fought the best of the
Serious?
Best.
Oh, I didn't know that.
A win tonight for Green would be huge and a great debut for Marzano.
Maurice Green used to weigh 330 pounds, took up kickboxing, lost a ton of weight. He's now 265, about 15 pounds lighter than his last glory fight against Chai Lewis Perry. And an uppercut.
Wow. Oh, whoa. Oh, holy crap! That wasn't expected. No, he's wobbly. He was too much wobbly. Wow! This is sick!
He
was wobbly. It was even that fast. I didn't even see it.
Marzano basically
wow, on the jaw.
All of his weight clipped the chin of Green. Glory debut for Marzano.
Here's your strike count. Not a ton of kicks to talk about, but the punches. 35 landed for Marzano, including a left hand for the ages. Let's make it official with Tim Hughes.
Ladies and gentlemen, you watched it as it happened. We have an official time of just 23 seconds of that second round.
He's still not there.
Referee Dave Smith steps in and waves it off for your winner by technical knockout, Gottlieb Marzano.
Glory had to be patient in order to sign Catalin Marzano. Had some other commitments. They've been after him for years. Now we've got him, Joe.
Another Romanian, and this is also a good fight. Benjamin Adegboye versus Anderson Silva.
267 pounds.
You can see it's that big reach of advantage for Adegboye that's going to give Anderson Silva a little bit of a tough time trying to use his
I'm really curious what it's going to be because Adegboye has the he has the opposite. He has the better side if you watch the television tape. But Anderson Silva is a good fighter. Benjamin Adegboye being the training partner of Rico Verhoeven.
Close to the same. Striking accuracy also relatively close. Strikes landed per minute, though. Look at the output of Adegboye, almost 12 a minute.
Adegboye is very good at staying active with his straight punches, and He's a very efficient kickboxer in that he uses light punches to set up power punches, and that's what makes him very efficient as a kickboxer.
It's now time for our glory rules.
Let's go.
Punches, kicks, knees are illegal. Three knockdowns in a round, four in a fight, and it's a TKO.
Let's take a look at the scoring system. Judges will be using the 10-point must system, looking for knockdowns, damage inflicted, and an emphasis on clean scoring strikes with spectacular techniques. If there's still no advantage, judges will look at aggressiveness.
For the official ring introductions now, we go inside the ring.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is your headline super fight of the evening. Three rounds in the heavyweight division, featuring two of the world's top 10. With their sights firmly fixed on getting the sport's biggest prize, the Glory Championship belt. This bout sanctioned by
title
the
fight.
Illinois State Athletic Commission. And up the opening bell, your referee is Chris Wagner. For those with us live here inside Sears Center, to Glory kickboxing fans watching in over 175 countries around the world, it's time for Glory! Introducing first, fighting out of the black corner, he is a Brazilian cruiserweight champion, now ranked number 10 in the Glory World Rankings. His record stands at 40 wins, 15 losses, one bout scored even, 25 of those wins by knockout. At 6'3" 1/2", 1.92 meters, he weighed in at an even 247 pounds, 112 kilos, fighting out of Sao Paulo, Brazil. Here is Anderson
Braddock Silva.
His opponent standing on my left and fighting out of the white corner, a two-time Glory Contender Tournament champion.
He looks fierce.
The number one challenger in the division. His record 27 wins with just four losses, 16 of those wins coming by knockout. At 6'6" tall, 1.98 meters, he weighed in at 267 1/2 pounds, 121.3 kilos. Fighting out of Transylvania, Romania.
Transylvania.
Mr. Gentleman.
The hometown of Dracula.
And your referee in charge in this bout is Chris Wagner.
The little LL Cool J. This is going to be a fair fight.
Quite the wild and woolly affair we just saw between Morisano and Mo Green. What kind of fight will it be?
This is going to be a lot more technical, and you're going to see Adekwuri really trying to establish those straight punches. And I'm very curious to see how Anderson Silva is going to react to those.
Both these fighters prefer to ease into the fight, unlike our last fight, where they just came out guns blazing. Todd Grisham, Joseph Baltolini, Whitney Miller with you here from the rocking Sears Center in Chicago. This is our main event of the Glory Super Fight Series. Anderson Silva in the black gloves and Benjamin Adekwuri wearing white.
So already you see the output of Adekwuri slowing down. That means they respect the counterpunching of Braddock.
You should respect it.
Especially in the first few rounds where Braddock's has all his energy and full power. That's why Adekwuri staying very tight and technical.
Adekwuri so big, strong, and powerful. He is a specimen, but don't expect Silva to be intimidated in the least bit. He's faced the best for sure.
Yeah, and Anderson Silva is really good at attacking that liver, so you're going to really see him mixing that left hook to the body and left kicks to the liver. He had a beautiful left kick liver knockout against Gordon Help at Glory 32 Virginia. There he goes, attacking that liver with that left hook.
Adekwuri coming off a tournament victory in Nice, France. He won twice in one night, but a connecting, I believe, left hand from Anderson Silva. Best punch of the round.
Yeah, Anderson Silva's doing a really good job. But it's Adekwuri really trying to use his counter punching too, right back.
There's an uppercut as Adekwuri opens up a little bit. I think that punch from Silva got his attention. He's woke now.
Remember, Adekwuri's training partner is Rico Verhoeven, and Rico Verhoeven beat Anderson Silva with low kicks, so yep. Adeboye might utilize the low kicks as the fight progresses.
Change stances. Again.
It's been a closer competitive round one. Not quite what we expected. We thought Adeboye would be a little bit more dominant, but Silva coming to fight here tonight. Yeah, they're really respecting Silva's counter hooks, which it did do damage with that one big shot from Silva.
Bill! Let's go, 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 go!
Team for Adeboye. It is not a title fight, so it's not five rounds, it's just three.
Oh, I thought it was a title fight.
Our main event.
Of course, it can't be a title fight, because else you would have thought we could win at this point. 23 rounds, I was expecting five.
And would your message to Adeboye perhaps be a little bit more busy?
I'd like Adeboye to really use that reach like he just did there. Use his jab, move back a little bit, keep the space. That jab, and maybe follow some kicks off of that. Maybe a straight right, but I think Adeboye is most successful when he stays active. You don't want Anderson Silva close.
Nice.
That uppercut just missed.
Good job. There it goes. Straight punch to low kick.
And wow, that uppercut landed.
Silva. And Silva does a good job, and after he hits that counter punch, he's moving his head because Adeboye has a counter hook waiting right back. Low kicks are open for Adeboye, so you're going to see a lot of punch-to-kick combinations now.
Ooh,
Silva walking
aggressive.
With his hands down. You don't see that a lot from him.
Wow, nice combination. Left right.
Definitely a better round for Adeboye.
Whoa, nice high kick. Oh, that cut him wobbly. Wow, he's indeed off balance.
Not sure if Silva's aware of it. Look at Adeboye. Knees, legs, not quite 100%.
Roddick's got to put some pressure in.
You can see what happens. What happens if you lose your concentration a little bit.
And Silva does a good job that he constantly kicks the liver with his left kick. And then he kind of switches it and cuts it down to a left high kick.
That was a nice, left high kick.
He's got to be a little bit more active.
Adeboye by no means is dominating this fight.
I think he
fight.
Didn't notice him.
We mentioned Silva could have won the first round, and he might well be winning the second.
That's that left hook mixed with uppercuts. Adeboye needs to stick with those low kicks. Don't get punch hungry.
There's a high kick of his own. Trying to follow up with a 1-2 and then a knee, but he goes down. It's a slip. Half minute to go here in round two.
Oh, that landed.
Adeboye is most successful when he uses his jab and his low kick. He doesn't want... He shouldn't be letting Anderson get so close to him like this. He's got to establish straight punches. He's letting Anderson get on the inside and get his punches off.
Give credit to Silva's game plan. It's working quite well here.
10 seconds.
A left-hand counter punch connects.
That's his famous shot, that counter left hook.
Well, Joe, we might be in the midst of a big upset here. How do you... The first two
really
rounds
curious.
Easily could have gone to Silva. And if that's the case, perhaps, just perhaps, we'll get an extra round. Let's find out as we go inside the ring now in Tim Hughes.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds, we go to the judges' scorecard. Here now are the totals.
The totals.
Judge Janicek scores the bout 29-27 on Adeboye.
Hmm.
Judge Puccio scores the bout 28-28. And Judge D'Amato scores the bout 28-28. So? It is a majority draw.
Not a round.
But according to Glory rules, we go one more round.
One more round.
Here we go, Joe. Batten down the hatches. We're going to an extra round here in our heavyweight main event. Who do you... If you're Anderson Braddock Silva. Here we go. Three more minutes.
It's good that they haven't unbuttoned their glove and wrapped their glove yet.
Jab and low kick that's Adekwui's going to constantly throw, and that's where that efficiency comes. He's going to touch, rip the low kick, or really look for those left hooks to the body. But Silva's still got that power in his punches. He sure does, and he's backing Adekwui up.
Wow.
Big uppercut. And Silva's
it's gone. It's done. It's done.
What an uppercut from the Romanian.
Just call it. Just call it. Oh, he's gonna finish.
Are you okay? Silva's ready to go. Woo-hoo. And Benjamin Adekwui running right at him. Starting out with a low kick and now going upstairs.
Silva's gonna
stay defensive. A referee's looking at him close. Silva fighting back. He's not gonna go down without a fight. Silva's just gonna hold this shield and see if he can rip off counter punches. That's his best option now.
Yep.
Sit there and try to whip off counter punches. Especially while Adekwui kicks, that's the time Silva needs
Adekwui
to throw a punch.
Was more energetic and more energy left.
Man. It started slow, but it's finishing fast. At this point, Silva needs a knockdown.
He's not gonna get knocked down yet. He gets knocked down probably himself.
And then
more easy.
Uppercut. Silva looked like he got frozen there for a second.
Yeah.
I don't know how much he has left. He just missed that right hand.
He's going down.
Silva's hands are down. He was doing better when he was against the ropes, Joe.
Yeah, he needs to stay against the ropes. I think that's his best option. Because this way, Adekwui just keeps...
He doesn't deserve to get beaten down
like
this, though. That's the rules of the fight.
By the Brazilian here in our main event. He's still landing his own punches.
He slipped in a few uppercuts.
Man of defense.
Going for the KO shot.
And a right hand from Silva. Raises the temple. The crowd chanting, Benny, Benny.
Wow.
And now look at Silva, still coming forward though, Joe.
Yeah, that
still
just shows the heart and the experience of Silva. He's been and taken shots from some of the best, and you gotta think he's even fought Daniel Guida, one of the best low kickers in kickboxing.
Yeah.
So 30 seconds for Silva to come up with something magical here.
Anticipating those low kicks. Silva's really relying on his uppercuts on the inside.
Adekwui told us how fit he was. How
fit as a damn fiddle.
He was in, and he's proven it. Still throwing some very strong power punches here in an extra round. 10 seconds to go.
Whoa. Hurt.
Body kick from Adekwui. Another one.
Anderson Silva can count it back.
It's done. So we don't have to wait the official. Well, let's keep it down. The official ruling of the judges, because he knocked him down, and they only needed one round to go. Silva had no defense left, no offense left. He threw a couple punches, but actually I would have stopped it already at the knockdown. But I'm no judge, I'm no referee, because he was only getting more damage, and that's not good for the next fight. So. If you like this video, please like, share and subscribe. Be sure to check me out on Twitter or on Facebook. You can see you can see my name of the Twitter and the shithole at the end of this video, and I will put it down in the description below, so you can follow me there. And please do so, because if something is delayed or whatever, I will put it on Twitter and you can be updated. So thank you for watching, and see you for next reaction video. Ciao.